for a second. And let's just offer a hand praise to the Lord. Let's offer a hand praise to the Lord. Makes no difference what the world may say. I'm going through. The Lord swear unto your fathers, and thou shalt remember all the way which the Lord thy God led thee these 40 years in the wilderness, to humble thee and to prove thee and to know what was in thine heart, whether thou wouldest keep his commandment or no. And he humbled thee and suffered thee to hunger, and fed thee with manna, which thou knewest not, neither did thy father know, that he may make thee know that man doth not live by bread only, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of the Lord doth man live. Thy raiment wax not old upon thee, neither did thy foot swell these 40 years. Thou shalt also consider in thine heart, that as a man chasteneth his son, so the Lord thy God chasteneth thee. Therefore thou shalt keep the commandments of the Lord thy God to walk in his ways, and so fear him. For the Lord thy God bringeth thee into a good land, a land of brooks of water, of fountains of depth that spring out the valleys and hills, a land that wheat and barley and vines and fig trees and pomegranates, a land of olive oil, oil, olive, and honey, a land wherein thou shalt eat bread without scarceness, thou shalt not lack anything in it, a land whose stones are iron, and out of whose hills thou mayest dig brass. Pause there for a second to give you our subject. And our subject is simply entitled, I am coming out with the victory. Amen. I've got to keep my eyes on the prize. Amen. I'm coming out with the victory. I've got to keep my eyes on the prize. As it is recorded in Deuteronomy chapter 8, Moses is reminding the people of which God has promised them. And he was basically taking them back through the history of the testimony of the power of the true and living God. He reminded them that when they were in bondage and they cried unto the Lord delivered them. And God said to them that I'm going to bring you to a place that's flowing with milk and honey. And Moses was telling them that God brought you to a place where you could do nothing for yourself, that he might humble you, that he might prove you. And he says that when you were hungry in the wilderness, he fed you with manna. But he said, I want you to be mindful that your wilderness experience was like a father who chasteneth his child, not because I'm angry with you or because I don't love you, but the father chases his son for correction that he might receive what he has for him. Now, he said, only if thou will keep the commandments of the Lord thy God to walk in his ways and fear him. Look what it says. He says, the Lord will bring you to a good land, a land of brooks, of waters, of fountains, depths, and the spring of valleys and hills, a land of wheat, hard barley, and vines, and fig trees, and pomegranates, and oil of olive, and honey. In other words, God said, the things that God, Moses said, the things that God has promised you, the provision has already been made, but you've got to make up in your mind, I'm going through, because I've got the victory, but I've got to keep my eyes on the prize. I'm going somewhere, and I've been instructed to take my time to help you get there, because even this past week for myself, and difficulties on the job, and things going on all around, and it just felt like sometimes that my back was going to bend, and my back was breaking from the pressure. But God has a way of reminding you, just trust me. You got to understand, even as the Lord spoke into my spirit, you're coming out with the victory. But you got to keep your eyes on the prize. It's no wonder somebody wrote, I will keep my eyes on the hill from where cometh my help. Because my help cometh from the Lord. Anybody in here has made the Lord your help? Anybody in here know you're coming out with the victory? But you got to go through. Watch this. Deuteronomy 8:10 says, and when thou hast eaten and art full, look what he says, when thou art eaten and art full, then shalt thou bless the Lord thy God for the good land which he hath what? I'm coming out with the victory. But I've got to keep my eyes on the prize. See, a lot of times people think that the prize is the thing that you pray for. A lot of times people think the prize is the thing that you travail for. But I come to realize that the prize is God himself. God is going to help me here. If I keep my eyes on the Lord, he'll satisfy the longing of my soul.
He said, when you come into the land and you receive the things I have given you, don't forget to give praise to the one who gave it to you. When you got what you asked for, don't forget who it was that gave it to you. Oh, watch this. He said, beware. Look at the warning. Moses said, beware, children, that thou forget not the Lord, thy God, in not keeping his commandments and his judgments and his statutes, which I command thee this day. Look at what he says. Lest when thou hast eaten and art full and hast built goodly houses and dwelt therein, and when there are herds and thy flocks multiplied and thy silver and thy gold is multiplied and in all that thou hast is multiplied, then thine heart, look at here, lift up and thou forget the Lord thy God and brought thee forth. You got to remember you're coming out with the victory, but you got to keep your eyes on God. Because when I look at the wilderness experience, God moved. And when he moved by a pillar of fire by night, they were to move too. When he moved as a pillar of cloud by day, they were to move. When he stopped, they were to stop. They were going to the promise, but they had to keep their eyes on the prize. Here we are. We rejoice after receiving what we ask God for. And one of the things I found out, it doesn't matter what you receive in this earth, it has an expiration. I don't care if you pay $10,000 for your car or $110,000. Everything man made has a point in time where it's going to break down or it's going to die. So when you pray for houses, when you pray for cars, I mean, no, those things are corruptible. But all I want is more of the Lord. All I want is more of Jesus. Because he gets sweeter than the day before. I'm coming out with the victory. I got to keep my eyes on the prize. Psalms 118, starting with verse 71, says it this way. As the psalmist says, it is good for me that I have been afflicted, that I might learn thy statutes. Anybody ever been sick? It was good for me to be sick, Uncle Junior, that I might know that he's a healer. It was good for me to find myself between a rock and a hard place, so that I might know he's a way maker. It was good for me to have everybody that turned their backs on me, that I know that he's a friend that sticketh closer than a brother. It was good for me that I lost all my finances, that I might know. Y'all ain't gonna help me here. He'll cause men to get under your bosom, pressed down, shaken together, running over. Y'all ain't gonna help me here. I feel my help. I'm coming out with the victory, but I gotta keep my eyes on the prize. He said, it is good for me that I have been afflicted, that I may learn thy statutes. The law of thy mouth is better unto me than thousands of gold and silver. Y'all gotta help me here. The psalmist just reminded us again, the prize isn't the things, but the prize is God himself. Look what he said. Thy hands have made me and fashioned me. Give me understanding that I may learn thy commandments. They that fear thee. Look at him. Anybody in the struggle. You saw me broken down. You saw me helpless. You saw me hurting and even bleeding. Oh, but I'm coming out. And now that you see me, you'll know that it was the Lord that brought me. Hallelujah. Don't worry about your situation. You're coming out with the victory. But keep your eyes on the prize. Watch this. Watch this. He says, I know, O Lord, that thy judgments are right. Yeah, God, I'm convinced that the way that you're bringing me is the way that I need to go. I'm convinced now that you won't put any more on me than I am able to handle, and with that temptation that you would make a way of escape. So if I'm in it, I'm coming out. Y'all ain't gonna help me here. Today, if I'm sick, I'm coming out. If I'm lonely, I'm coming out. But I gotta keep my eyes on the prize. Faithfulness has afflicted me. It ain't the devil that did this to me. It was God that I might know him in the fullness of his power. Y'all gonna help me here. It wasn't Satan that had the Hebrew children in the wilderness. It was God. What was God trying to do? God was proving them to themselves. God was manifesting his glory. Because every time they said we have a need, God brought it down. Oh, haven't you seen that God has met every one of your needs? Haven't you found out that there is no good thing that he would withhold from you if you walk uprightly before him? And if you ask for it and you haven't received it, it's because it's not for you. Because what he has for you is better than you can ask or think. Watch this. Watch this. He says, let I pray thee, thy merciful kindness be for my comfort, according to thy word, unto thy servant out of the land of Egypt, from the house of bondage. Now, I gotta remember what you already did. Because this thing that I'm in right now is no different than what you brought me out of last year. This thing that I'm facing right now is no different than what you did for the saints of old. Oh, y'all ain't gonna help me here. This sickness that I'm facing right now is no different than the bomb that you applied in Gilead. This sickness that I'm facing right now is no different than the woman who had the issue of blood. I'm coming out, but I gotta keep my eyes on the prize. Yes, it feels like we're being bombarded on every side. Yes, it feels like every time you try to go forward, you feel like you get knocked back two paces. But honey, I'm telling you, get ready for what God's about to bring you to. Oh, he's preparing your character. He's preparing you for things you can't even understand yet. He's bringing you to a level in your faith so that when the enemy comes, rather than you being afraid, rather than you being angry, you learn to say, okay, God, you were with me when the lion and the bear came. And now that I'm standing before this giant, I know you're going to see me through. Tell your neighbor, I'm coming out. Y'all ain't saying that like you can rent. Tell your neighbor. get back to the history of this thing. So you can see this. And made it relative to your own present situation. In Numbers chapter 13. Starting with verse 25. Numbers chapter 13, starting with verse 25. Joshua sends out the spies. They go in to inspect whether that which Moses told them is true or not. God already told you what he's going to do for you. But you don't trust him, so you got to go and inspect. And what's this? Numbers chapter 13, starting verse 25 says, and they returned from searching of the land after 40 days. And they went and came to Moses and to Aaron and to all the congregation of the children of Israel unto the wilderness of Paran to Kadesh, and brought back word unto them and unto all the congregation, and showed them the fruit of the land. Somebody said the fruit of the land. What does that mean? That means we got the evidence that what God said is true. We have the evidence that what God said is true. Verse 27 says, and they told him and said, we came unto the land whither thou sendest us, and surely, what's that word? Surely. Not surely. Not Big Shirley or Shirley, you know, down the street, but surely. Surely. It floweth with milk and honey. Semicolon. And this is what? Not only did we see what God said, but we are back here to present you some of what the land has to offer.
Amen.
Look at verse number
28.
Nevertheless, the people be what?
Strong.
That dwell
in the land.
And the cities are
long.
And very
great.
And moreover, we saw
the children
and at there. Now see, they were coming out with a victory, but they took their eyes off the prize. What was the prize? The prize was God. See, somebody said, well, the prize was what they asked for. The prize was what they were expecting. That's not the prize, because you see right here, they had the evidence where? They had in their hands what God promised. Do y'all see that? They had in their hands what God promised, and that wasn't enough for them to do what? Trust God. Yeah, y'all ain't helping
yes.
me.
Yes.
So, if you are going to receive the victory, you got to take your eyes off of even the things you're looking for.
Amen.
And you got to keep your eyes on God.
Yes.
Amen. Y'all ain't seen
yes.
this.
Yes. 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 Hallelujah.
We have the evidence in our hands.
Amen.
But brother pastor, before we can accept what has been said, nevertheless. The nevertheless is like the B-U-T, but. Meaning, it is what it is, but I've got another thought. So what they're saying is, we have the evidence of what God says, but we saw some oppositions. How many of you believe what God said in your life? How many of you believe what God said for your life? Y'all saying like, yes, I believe, but I don't know if I'm going to raise my hand too high. I believe what God said. But you know what? Every obstacle obstacle that I'm presently dealing with is a part of the process. And what we do is we look at the process rather than keep our eyes on God. Because where was God? I'm going to show you where God was. Watch this. We saw Anak children there. We saw the Amalekites. He said the Amalekites dwell in the land of the south, and the Hittites and the Jebusites and the Amorites dwell in the mountains, and the Canaanites dwell by the sea and by the coast of Jordan. What did that just tell y'all? What did that just tell y'all? That just told you that God made us invisible. Because we walk past the Amalekites, we walk past the Hittites, we walk past this nation and that nation, and we came through their land taking their goods, and we are back here to tell you what God did. Yes, yes. Oh, y'all missed that. Yes, yes. These people who had the ability to kill us couldn't touch us.
Amen. Hallelujah.
The enemy that has tried to stop you can't stop you because God is with you. Y'all ain't helping me here. But you're so busy looking at who you're going past, who's with you, who's affecting you, who's here. Who, now, honey, take your eyes off of them and put your eyes back on the prize. Because he's...
Hallelujah.
Let me give y'all some more. Let me give you 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 some more.
Yeah.
Let me give you some more. Watch this. And Caleb stilled the people before Moses and said what? Let us go up at once and possess it. For we are what? We are well able to overcome it.
Amen. Yes.
We need some Calebs. We need some people with the spirit Caleb around us. You got people around you always making you feel bad about your bad. You need to get them away from you. You got people trying to pacify you. When they need to say, honey, let me take something. It's going to be hard, but you know what? I would suggest you go in the back room, exercise, a little workout, build up your muscles, you know, get your cardios up so that when you can't stop for a break, you can push yourself a little bit further. Because we got to go through this to get out. Kelsey, look at here. All this stuff y'all talking about, we got the evidence in our head, and God is with us. We are well able. Anybody feel like you well able? Okay. You may say, Pastor, I'm getting there, but I'm not there yet. And that's okay. But I want you to keep your eyes on the prize. Because watch this. Look what he says. He says, but the men that were up, who went up with him, said what?
We are not able to go up against the people.
For
they are stronger than we.
For
they are stronger than we.
For
they are stronger than we.
They just gave themselves their own testimony. Here's what the Bible tells you. What the Bible tells you. The Bible tells you when your enemies are encamped around you. What did he say? Come on, y'all gonna help me here. When your enemies are encamped around you, he said, the psalmist said, he would prepare a table for me in the presence of my. They trying to distract me, but I'm eating. What am I eating? I'm feasting at the master's table. Y'all ain't gonna help me here. The enemy's creeping in on the backside. They're trying to come in on my right. Because when I'm weak, well, y'all ain't gonna talk to me. They're stronger than I am. So lift up a standing, God. They're bigger than I am. So lift up a standing. Watch this. Verse 32 of Numbers 13. And they brought up an evil. Evil what?
Report.
Of the land which they had what?
Search.
Until?
The children of Israel.
What did they say?
The land.
The land. together. Because somebody, this is where you failed. I want everybody to read it together. Well, what's this? Yeah, y'all get that? Got it? Verse number 32 of Numbers 13. On three. One, two, three.
And
the land through which we have gone to search it is a land that what? Stop. Key words. They devise how they're going to go in and attack the enemy. Sometimes when you pray, the Lord's letting you see who and where your enemy is. Sometimes when you read your Bible, He'll let you hear voices of people plotting against you. Y'all ain't talking to me. Instead of you rejoicing that no weapon formed against you can prosper, you getting upset with the people. You got the victory, but you got your eyes on the wrong thing. Because I love it when I see where my enemy is.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
See, I wish more of y'all had the opportunity to play football.
Jesus.
When I played football, I was on one of the specialty teams, the punt team. So I went from playing offense to defense when we punted the ball because we didn't meet our goal. So the objective for me was to go in and tackle the man who has captured the ball.
Amen.
But with that, I have to run down the field as fast as I can, but I have to also be mindful that the defense is trying to block me from getting to the offense with the ball.
Hallelujah.
So that means I can't run with my head up and not looking where I'm going, but I've got to run with my head on the swivel. Somebody's trying to block me. Y'all ain't talking to me. God allows you to see where your enemy is. Somewhere they're trying to catch you. I'm still standing. I'm coming through with the victory. I got to keep my eyes on the prize. The devil thought he was going to take you out. But he didn't see that God made a way of escape for you. The devil thought he was going to cause you to lose your mind. But he didn't realize that what he brought into your life took you to your knees. And rather than losing your mind, you take it on the mind of Christ. Let me finish this. Verse 32 again of Numbers 13 says, and they brought up an evil report of the land which they had searched unto the children of Israel. That's why you got to be careful how you share your visions and your dreams with people.
Oh, yes. Yes, God.
Don't go opening yourself to everybody. Because everybody, though they're at the church, are not vessels and voices of God.
Amen.
Amen. Meaning, good-hearted church folks will kill the word that God has planted in you as a seed and have you doubting the very God who gave you the word.
Amen.
Oh, they say things like, well, you know, if I were you, I'd be careful. If I were you, you need to take it easy because That seems like that's too much for you, but you got to understand, if God has me in it, he's already equipped me. Yeah, y'all ain't helping me. Because see, what people didn't realize, it takes me back to when I played football again. I can only relate to myself. My mama couldn't understand how I could be out there hit with all those people and not get injured. So there was this one guy, he was 350 pounds, and I remember he was like the nose guard for the opposing team, and all his purpose was to just fall and clog up the hole. Because if we were trying to run up the middle, all he had to do was fall, and our people couldn't get past him. So my coach devised a plan, because I was the fastest lineman, that before he fall, I was to knock him out of the way. And if he fell, I was to keep my feet chopping and move him out of the hole. So my mama saw this big fella falling on me a few times. And in the midst of all those hundreds of people, I heard, "Don't fall on my baby." See, what my mama didn't realize was, when I was getting up at 5 o'clock in the morning in the summer and going to the gym to work out for my first football practice, and then going back at 5:30 for the second football practice, was preparing me for the Giants. See, some of you don't realize that you let people minimize where you've been in prayer and minimize your time studying. They're looking at your frailty and they look at you and say, "But you smaller than, honey, don't worry about my size, because you don't see who is with me. I can equip in myself that every giant that comes in my life, if I gotta get on my knees, mother, I'm gonna pray and tell her, y'all ain't gonna help me here." Because one thing I found out, this kind can only come up by fasting and praying. So you just think I'm acting funny because I'm not eating. You just think I'm trying to act cute because I don't want your food. Honey, it's not about any of those things. Because the Bible tells me when I fast, to fast in secret. And just because I didn't tell you I wasn't eating because I'm looking for a breakthrough, it's none of your business. But I believe that I'm at the place now where I got my flesh in line. I got my mind fixed on the prize. I don't see obstacles anymore. All I see is the Lord say, you know, get that. When my airplane is about to land, the flag man is doing this right here. You're in the right place. In other words, stop looking at people. Keep your eyes on them. God's telling you, come on, you got the victory. You're home safe now, but you gotta make it here. Too much to do today. Woo! So I'm gonna finish it. But watch this. Numbers chapter 13, verse 33. And then prepare yourself to go to Numbers chapter 14, verse 1. It says, "And there we saw the giants, the sons of Anak, which come, and of the giants. And we were in our what? We were what? Now, the enemy didn't say this. God didn't tell you this. Where did you get convinced of this? In your own mind. Where did the seed come from? The negative reports. Oh, yes, I'm listening to people. You know, sometimes people think that I'm funny because when they start talking to me, I either walk off or I go into a zone where you're talking, but you're not even there. Because you got to guard your soul.
Because
when you get down to pray, them voices be coming back to you. See, I get my greatest messages in the shower. So while the water is running and I'm doing a solo or a concert to the Lord, the enemy try to come in with all the crazy conversations that have been trying to get in my head. And they can't penetrate because I don't even focus in on them. They're on the outside. It's kind of like right there.
Jesus.
You know they're there, but all you got to do is just keep on moving because it can't come in. You got to open yourself. And what you got to stop doing is quit being so curious. Stop trying to figure out why they say that. I don't care why they say that. It ain't what God said. Don't y'all understand that?
Oh, my Savior.
People have been telling me for the last 20 years of my life, you need to be careful. You don't want people to get the wrong impression. You know what? The Lord gave me this scripture one day when I heard that the last time. He says, when man's ways please with God, I'll make even your enemies be at peace with you. Stop worrying about people.
Amen.
You know why? Because I don't want to be so good at what I do because I don't want people to think I think I'm better than they are.
Jesus.
I don't want to appear to be excellent because people don't think, oh, he think he's all that. Yes, I do. And that's why I take the time to do it well, because I'm doing it as unto God. How many of you don't think of yourself as special because God gave you a gift? You ain't talking to me.
Amen.
When I'm sitting at a computer designing something or putting it together, I got this look on my face like,
that's it.
What you saying, God? What you saying? Add a little purple there? Okay. Somebody look at me like, you think you that? Yeah, I'm all that and more. Because my instructions is coming from the Lord. Y'all ain't hear me.
Amen.
That's what you need to do. You need to keep your eyes on the prize. Because I'm so comfortable right now in the season of my life. It's scary.
Yeah. Amen.
With all the stuff that the enemy's been trying to bring into my life to knock me off course and everything else. But I'm in a place right now where I'm so comfortable in the season of my life, because it's like every time I turn around, God's giving me new instructions. And the instructions are not things that people are telling me.
Amen.
It's just coming out of my heart.
Amen.
Y'all hear me?
Amen.
People say, well, you know, is that a good idea to be doing that right now? Can I borrow something from the world from about 15 years ago? How many of y'all remember Talk to the Hand?
Yeah.
We need to borrow that, bring that back. People start talking and saying crazy. Because you don't need that. You can't get it into your spirit. Because the reason why the Israelites were defeated, although they had the evidence, mother, is because they allowed negative reports to penetrate and go beyond where God's word ended. God's word didn't even settle in their spirits before they got allowed the negativity to take control. Caleb says, I got a feeling that we were able. Because that thing that God said through Moses to Caleb and those got in his core. And he said, I can't be defeated if God is on our side. How do y'all feel that way? Trouble on every side. Five more minutes. Numbers 14. We're going quickly. Numbers 14 and 1 says, and all the congregation lifted up their voice and cried, and the people wept that night.
Jesus.
Why? Because they saw themselves as defeated. I ain't crying because I feel defeated. If I cry, it's because I'm supplicating before the Lord. I ain't crying because I don't know what to do. I always know what to do. I can go to the rock.
Amen.
But look at this. Look at this. Numbers 14 and 2 says, and all the children of Israel murmured against Moses and against Aaron and the whole congregation of them, what God that we in the land that you had left us were miserable. Because at least I was learning how to what? To deal with it.
Amen.
Anybody ever feel like that? Yeah. My old misery was better than misery? Because at least I was. I don't want no misery.
Amen.
That makes sense what I'm saying? I can be all around me, but I ain't gonna let me. Yeah. I don't get what I'm saying.
Oh, yeah.
Anybody experience any arthritic pains or sciatic pains in their backs or this or that? It's a pain that you can only get used to. Because it's constant. And a lot of times the doctor says, we want to do surgery. And you'll say to the doctor, doctor, I'm not going to get cut because I've already learned how to deal with this pain.
Yes, 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 yes.
But it'll make you feel better. But that's a new pain I have to get used to.
Oh, yes, oh, yes.
So some people are like that. I'd rather hold on to the old pain because at least I embrace it.
Yes.
Then they have to go to a new season of new pain. But see, what you don't realize is sometimes the new pain is only temporary because it's going to fix. Y'all ain't going to help me here. God going to have to heal you in order to heal you. Oh, see, I got to go into my medical. I got to go into my medical closet. If a bone is broken, oftentimes they have to snap it to set it. And I heard that the snapping sometimes is worse than the initial breaking.
Amen. Jesus.
Y'all ain't talking to me. Oh, but after the cast comes off,
Jesus.
And you've gone into some physical therapy,
Jesus.
And you can walk like you used to walk,
Jesus.
You can move like you used to move, Jesus. New pain, worth the process. I'm coming out with the victory. I've got my eyes on the prize. Watch this. Look what he says. He says, would that we would have died in Egypt, or would God we had died in this wilderness? Why God brought us here if he didn't have a plan? They already forgot what God said. He said, I'm taking you someplace. So where you are right now is not where he wants you to be.
Jesus.
It's a process. Look at the next thing. He says, and wherefore hath the Lord brought us unto this land to fall by the sword, that our wives and our children should be a prey? Were it not better for us to return into Egypt? Now y'all acting crazy. You just went through the Jebusites, the Hittites, all these other places. You got their products in your hand, and none of y'all got killed. How they gonna come in here and kill you when you just went in where they are and they couldn't kill you? Watch this. Verse 4. And they said one to another, be careful of them conversations you have with people.